Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about scalability testing, which is a non-functional testing method that measures performance of a system or network when the number of user requests are scaled up or down. So let's consider one example here. So let's say we have a festival season. During this festival season, people are attracting towards e-commerce website. So generally, in scalability testing, the users or the tester is testing how much load will the application is bear when we have maximum customer interactions. The purpose of scalability testing is to ensure that the system can handle projected increase in user traffic, data volume, transactions count, frequency, etc. It tests system ability to meet the growing needs. System or application must have the capability to function flawlessly under excessive load. Scalability testing features the process where the efficiency of a system is tested based on growing number of user requests, data volume, transactions, and user traffic. The developers identify the points where the system stops responding to changes and dig deeper to find its reason. So we see here, what is scalability testing? Objective of scalability testing, why we need to perform scalability testing, types of scalability testing, features, and how to perform the scalability testing in detail. So if you're visiting this channel first time and wanted to understand the complete software testing, then please watch my software testing playlist. I will also include the URL in description tab so that it will easy for you to refer it. So let's begin. Here, scalability testing, as I said, we are verifying the overall performance of applications or website where the user is having maximum outreach. So this is a non-functional and non-purposeful trying out of software program. It is used to test an application's overall performance with the aid of using, growing, or reducing the burden, especially skills called scalability testing. It is done at hardware, software, or database level. It's totally depending on the application size. It's special because the ability of network system, applications, product, or manner to make the feature efficiently while the changes are made within sight, the system length or extends to satisfy and growing need. Come back to the same example of e-commerce website. Let's say any festival seasons are generally attracting more traffic on e-commerce site. Some of the e-commerce site is not working properly because of increase in customer load. So in that case, development team will make sure to develop the application in such a way when the traffic will increase, the application will work as earlier it was working. So here, the efficiency of system will be verified. And what we are trying to verify here, so it will tell us how the application behaves under heavy load. Then it will let us to know the limitation of the app in terms of user experience. It also helps us to determine the efficiency and limits of the server, and it gives insight into what our user will experience when during a system's software and server overload. So these all pointers we are verifying in detail in scalability testing. Now, what all objectives of scalability testing we have? So generally, the predominant goal of appearing the scalability testing trying out is to manipulate how the utility balances within a growing workload, and at that factor, how the software or program will work successfully. If we are finding any glitches in terms of application performance, then definitely that should be reported. The scalability testing trying out is wanted to indicate the consumer restricts for the software program product and to discover the client faces degradations and consumer involvement beneath load and server facet stability. The usage of scalability trying out while make certain the potentials of software program to scale up with the growing workload and records traffic. Why we need the performance of scalability testing? So generally, this is a very important part of any applications or website when the application's performance will be measured. Generally, this type of testing will be required in any of the applications or product to, for the certification's point of view. If the product is working perfectly fine with minimum number of users, that product should exactly work when the user's attraction will increase or user will trying to access that product in maximum extent. The execution of scalability trying out is needed as it guarantees the event functioning of the software program or the software event as finishing any user's necessities with none issues. So again, come back to the same e-commerce product, or let's consider one mobile applications like WhatsApp. So generally, the WhatsApp applications will be used mostly in the daytime, total depending on zone to zone basis, but within the daytime, that will be maximum usage of the applications will be required. If that product is not working perfectly fine, the people will not start using, or people will run out of the applications. So generally, the WhatsApp team or the WhatsApp development team, the owner team has managed in such a way the applications will work perfectly fine in any point of the time. So there is a no server delay, though there is a no glitches at the time of sending out the messenger or trying out a call or video calls. Now the scalability checking out is wanted if we stumble upon the subsequent issues. In case of any amendment within the site, software program lead us to its failure. So what does this mean? So within the software programs, generally when the traffic will increase, definitely the applications will not be have perfectly fine. So after the enhancement, the software program is operating successfully and successfully in assembly the person necessity and expectations. Whether the software program can produce and enhance as in line with the prolonged needs. So these are subsequent issues which we can face at the time of performing scalability testing. So which all types of scalability testing here? One is upward scalability and second is downward scalability. So let's understand what does it means about upward and downward scalability. So upward scalability, generally checking out is used to make bigger the variety of customer on a particular scale till we have given a crash point. It is especially used to pick out the most ability of an applications. And in other words, the downward scalability is working or checking out is downward scalability, which means when the weight checking out isn't always passed, we can use the downward scalability checking out, after which begin lowering the quantity of customer in specific C program language period till the intention is achieved. Therefore, we'll quick becomes aware of the bottleneck, that is a bug, through acting downward scalability checking out. So which all features we have in scalability testing? So first is throughput. So throughput features used to specify the amount of work implemented by the applications in the given time. So generally, let's say we are sending out the messages in WhatsApp applications. So how much time it is taking for the receiver and the sender who is sending this information. So these informations should not have delay in between it. So this is called as throughput. When the durations which is calculated is throughput time, we are calling as throughput time. The throughput can change from one application to the other applications. But when we are sending the same applications into the group, so are the same message will be delivered in the specific time of time, or it is taking a delay. So generally, the duration between the sender and receiver, so that duration is called as throughput time. Next is memory usage. So in scalability testing, memory utilization is one of the useful resources utilizations used to maintain the remnants expanded for acting or undertaking through an applications. So again, when we are using that applications, how much memory it will consume, and whenever we are doing for the longer durations, is that memory usage is increasing or we are almost at the same point of time. Next is network usage. How many network or bandwidth will be consumed by that applications? So sometimes when we are working in IPTV related applications are generally considering more bandwidth as compared to the other applications. So IPTV technologies itself taking out the 2 GB of space minimum required for Buffering. So in that case, how many bandwidths we are consuming for any particular applications? So if the bandwidth consumption is more, it means that application will not work in lower internet speed. So again, that is a raw fall of that applications. Then the performance measurement, the subsequent characteristics of scalability trying out is performance. So how the application is performing when we are doing advanced and when we are doing same activity repetitively. So beneath the web servers and repos of the system is performance, which will be captured. Then CPU usage. Another aid usage below scalability checking out is CPU usage and used to calculate it. The CPU usage while appearing utility code commands. Next is response time. That is the time used up among the application reactions and the user's request. So these all are the features of scalability testing. Now, how to perform scalability testing? First will be assessment will be required. So while starting with the scalability testing, we have to understand how the application's behavior is, how the application's flow, which all programs feasible growing potentials. They additionally test the standards of the scalability to determine the software program gear had to carry out the check. What all components are related with it, which all services are running in background. Then test executions is the second step of performing scalability testing. So after the assessments, we are able to put together the check plans. So which all scenarios we have to cover it, which all test cases are there, which call and examine the software running for every incremental development, which application we'll use for the manual and automations, how we can track, how we can report. So automations will be required or not, which are environments we can use. These all components will be required to cover or make sure to have within that test execution phase. Then the test development. So after that, we are able to set checking out the environment configurations, hardware requirement, software requirement. If it is servers are required, database access. So all the access related thing, then the setting up the environment is the major and important part, which all costs will be involved. And at the time of doing the repeated testing, how we'll perform it, how we'll measure the performance and their throughput. So these all factors will be included. And then logging and reporting and defect. And finally, when we are finding a defects, we have to report that in any applications. If we are not having any application present, definitely we have to do it through Excel sheet and report to the business team. This is the logging and reporting and defect. And at the end of that, we have to regularly send out the status of our execution. So these all status will be captured on the regular basis. So complete business teams are looking out on the regular updates of the testing. So these all performance measures we are keeping at the time of performing scalability testing. So that's all from this contain. Let's recap. We have started with the introduction of scalability testing. We have discussed which all components we have in scalability testing, the types of scalability testing, features of scalability testing. At the end, we have discussed how we can perform the scalability testing with the example. So that's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.